Hello friends, welcome to my channel Welding and NDT, and our today's topic is ultrasonic test. See, ultrasonic test is a very big topic and it cannot be covered in a one video itself. So I will make 6 to 7 videos to cover ultrasonic test, both theory as well as practical. So I'll look after both of these theory and practical, and it may take 6 to 7 videos to complete ultrasonic test. Friends, this video will be an introduction only. Introduction to UT and some basic concept I will explain in this video. Then I'll make the second video in which I'll explain about the machine calibration and DAC. Then I'll make normal beam, normal probe scanning video, and finally angle probe scanning video. So this is a one video. For machine calibration it may take 2 videos, for normal probe scanning it may take 2 videos, and for angle probe it may take 2 to 3 videos, 2 videos or 3 videos. So around 6 to 7 or 8 videos we can complete this ultrasonic test fully, 3 theory plus practical. So friends, before starting this video, I would request you to please subscribe my channel if you have not done it yet. Please subscribe my channel, and also if you really like the concept of my video, then please hit the like button. And if you don't like this video, then there is a thumbs down icon, or you can say dislike. So you can press that icon also. And friends, I would request you for your valuable comments. What are the things you like in my video, or what are the things you dislike in my videos? So please share your comments. Please hit like or dislike button as per your wish. And finally, I would request you to share this video with your friends on social media groups like WhatsApp, Facebook, Telegram, etc. So friends, let's start the topic. See, I will not explain in a trivial or conventional way. Rather, I would explain in a very different way. First, I will show you what is the basic principle of UT, means how UT is done. So for UT, you need one probe. There is a probe in UT. See, this is a probe. Probe is also called as search unit. So there will be a search unit in the UT, and this search unit is connected with the machine. This is our machine, and in the machine we'll have one screen, LCD screen. Now what it does, this machine will have a system through which it can generate electric pulses, electric pulse. So these electric pulses reaches to the probe through cable. There are many cable in ultrasonic test, like BNC to LEMO, LEMO to mini LEMO. So cable is basically to supply this electric pulse. Now what happens, this probe is made up of piezoelectric crystal or piezoelectric material. There is a piezoelectric material inside this probe. I'll write it down, piezoelectric material. Now what this piezoelectric material do is, see, this piezoelectric material have a phenomena, or it have a property by virtue of which it converts the electrical energy, or rather we can say electrical pulses, which is sent to the probe, to mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. So friends, this electrical pulses which is sent by this cable to the probe is converted into mechanical energy, and that mechanical energy is in the form of ultrasonic waves. Ultrasonic waves. So ultrasonic waves are a form of mechanical energy. So what happens? this ultrasonic waves which enters the, then enters in the test object. This is our test object which we are scanning or which we are checking. So the ultrasonic pulses enters into the test object and it travels completely in the test object, and at the boundary it again reflects back. It goes back to the piezoelectric material itself. Now this piezoelectric material have a very natural phenomena that this reverse process is also true in case of piezoelectric material. Means the mechanical energy or ultrasonic waves, the piezoelectric material can convert to electrical pulses. Means it can do both. It can convert electrical to mechanical and mechanical to electrical. So it has the capability to do both. Hence, when this ultrasonic waves travel and go back to the piezoelectric material, this piezoelectric material changes the ultrasonic waves to electrical signal, and that signal is received through a receiver. Here one receiver will be there. So that signal is received to a receiver, and in between that there will be a synchronizer. Synchronizer, which will synchronize these two signals. Now friends, what happens? On the CRT screen, a graph will be made and an echo will rise. From where? From the portion from which this ultrasonic waves gets reflected or go back, one echo will rise. And this echo is called as back wall echo. Back wall echo. This echo is called as back wall. There will be an initial pulse, then there will be echo from the boundary. Back wall, this location from which the back wall echo arises. That is the boundary back wall location. From here the back wall echo arises from the boundary. Now friends, suppose the thickness of this entire material is 100 mm. So this back wall echo will rise at 100 mm. Now, consider if there is any defect over here. So what will happen? In case of defect, the ultrasonic wave will reflect from this position itself. Now, since this is a 3D model, we are showing in 2D, so some of the waves will strike to the defect and will reflect, and some of the waves will go till the back wall position. So what will happen? Suppose this distance is x. So at x distance, one more echo will rise, and this echo will show the defect, that there is one defect. There is one defect in this material, and that location of this defect is at x mm. X mm down from the probe, there is one defect. So this is how a ultrasonic machine or ultrasonic test is carried out. Now we'll go one by one. First I talked about the ultrasonic waves which are generated by the piezoelectric material in the probe. So what is ultrasonic waves? So friends, I'll explain this. See, we have first infrasonic waves, then sonic waves. Sonic waves is also called as audible range of waves, and then ultrasonic. So sonic waves are those which is audible by human eye. Normal human eye can listen if it is in this range, and the range is 20 hertz. So 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. So if the ultrasonic waves, if the sonic waves are in this range, then it can be heard by a normal human eye. Hence it is called, also called as audible range. Now the range below this audible is called as infrasonic, that is less than 20 hertz. See, these waves are produced during earthquake. Hence we are not able to listen this, because this is below the range of our hearing range. This is below that range. That's why we cannot listen the earthquake sound. Now, ultrasonic is beyond this, above 20,000, more than 20,000 hertz is called as ultrasonic waves. So the waves which are used in ultrasonic test is having frequency more than 20,000 hertz. See, these are the frequency ranges. So frequency with more than 20,000 hertz are known as ultrasonic waves, and these waves are taken care during the ultrasonic test. Now, first I would like to clear some basic funda, that is, what is wave and what is frequency, what is wavelength, for those who don't know. So friends, wavelength, frequency. So what is frequency and what is wavelength? Suppose here we have a wave. This is a wave. Now, wavelength is the distance traveled to complete one cycle. For example, from here to here, one cycle completes. So this distance is known as wavelength, and it is denoted by lambda. So this is the wavelength of this wave. Distance covered by sound through one complete cycle. Distance covered by sight, again, from here to this point, one wavelength, from here to this point, another wavelength. So distance covered by sound through one complete cycle. In one complete cycle, this much distance will be covered. This is wavelength and denoted by lambda. Now frequency. So the frequency is nothing but the time taken to complete one cycle. Time taken to complete one cycle, or we can say number of cycles per second. Time taken to complete one cycle or number of cycles per second. For example, if here this is 1 second, means in 1 second, if this wave is completing one cycle, then the frequency of this wave will be 1 hertz. Suppose this is the 1 second. Now we'll take another example. Again, this is our 1 second. So within 1 second, how many cycles this wave has completed? From here to here, 1 cycle, and here to here, 2 cycles. Hence, 2 hertz. The frequency of this wave will be 2 hertz. We'll take another example. So from here to here, this is 1 second. Now, in 1 second, how many cycles this wave has made? So this is 1 cycle. From here to here, 2 cycles. From here to here, 3 cycles. So this will be 3 hertz. So likewise, number of cycles per second is called as frequency. Now friends, you can conclude from this that the higher the frequency, the smaller the wavelength. The higher the frequency, the smaller the wavelength. Here, only 1 hertz is frequency. So the wavelength is this much, 2 hertz frequency, wavelength is only this much, 3 hertz of frequency, wavelength is only this much. So as frequency is getting increases, wavelength is decreasing. Now, the formula for wavelength is lambda is equal to V by F. Lambda is the wavelength, as I explained, F is the frequency, this hertz, and V is the speed of ultrasonic wave, speed of ultrasonic wave or waves. So speed by frequency is equal to wavelength. Now friends, you might have understood this. Now with this, I would like to explain some more thing. I'll come back to this figure once again. Here I told you there will be a probe which will emit ultrasonic wave. Now there are three types of probes. Three types of probes are used in the industry. First one is normal probe. Second one is TR probe. And third one is angle probe. I will show you these probes to you also. First, let me explain what is normal probe. Friends, normal probe are those, for example, this is a normal probe in which it emits waves normal to the piezoelectric defect or normal to this surface. Here you can see it is coming perpendicular to this surface, or rather you can say in the axis of this probe. So this is how normal probe emits ultrasonic wave. Secondly, normal probe in this crystal, arrangements are made that the same piezoelectric material will transmit and same material will receive the ultrasonic waves. Whereas in TR probe, there will be partition. One side will transmit the ultrasonic waves and the other side will receive. So there is a partition in TR probe. And in angle probe, suppose this is an angle probe. So in angle probe, the ultrasonic waves emits at a certain angle. There are three types of angle probe which are very popular. That is 45 degree probe, 60 degree probe and 70 degree probe. Three types of probes are very popular in the industry. Now friends, I will show you practically the probes, these probes. So friends, these are the probes. Here you can see it is 2 megahertz, 24 dia 2 megahertz. And this is the face from where the ultrasonic waves are emitted. So here you can see one partition and here no partition is there. Now, as I had explained that one is normal probe and another one is TR probe. This one is normal probe. It transmits and receives from the same surface. But here partition is made and from one side transmission is done and from the other side receiving is done. So here you can also see that in TR probe, there is a provision of two cables. One cable for is transmitting and the other is for receiving. And in normal probe, only one cable is used for both transmitting and receiving. So this is 2 megahertz 24 dia. I have another probe also. This is 4 megahertz. You can see 4 megahertz and 10 dia. Here also you can see this one is normal probe. This is TR probe. Two partition is made. And here you can see provision for one cable in normal probe and provision for two cable in TR probe. Now normal and TR probe I have shown you. I'll show you angle probe. So friends, here you can see 8 into 9 mm. This is the size of the crystal. 60 degree. And see here, 60 degree is the angle at which ultrasonic waves are emitted and frequency of this probe is 4 megahertz. Here 45 degree and 4 megahertz frequency. So now we'll understand this 4 megahertz, 2 megahertz. Means how we have to select the frequency of the probe. One more thing, this 4 megahertz means The ultrasonic waves which will be emitted from this probe will be having the frequency of 4 MHz. Similarly, the ultrasonic waves which will be emitted from this probe will be having frequency of 2 MHz. So, what should be the selection criteria of the frequency of the probe? That I will explain now. So, first I will write it down. Selection of frequency. Or rather, to understand this term, first we should understand sensitivity. First we need to understand sensitivity, then we can understand sensitivity. Sensitivity. So first we'll understand the term sensitivity, then we automatically understood this point. Why this 4 MHz and 2 MHz? What is the reason for that? So friends, what is sensitivity? So sensitivity is the ability to detect the smallest discontinuity. What should be the size of the smallest discontinuity which the machine can detect? So the machine can detect the smallest size which the machine can detect is called its sensitivity. And sensitivity for an ultrasonic machine is lambda by 2. It was for earlier machines. In old days, CRT screens were used. So for those machines, the sensitivity was lambda by 2. For the newer machines, which I am also having, the sensitivity is, in these new machines, LCD screens are used. So the sensitivity is lambda by 4. Now, what does it exactly mean? I will explain you. Here I'll take a probe having frequency 4 MHz. And here I'll take a probe having frequency 2 MHz. And we'll see what happens next. So, one more thing I would like to tell you, friends. Lambda. First we'll find out the lambda, then we'll divide it by 4, then we can calculate the sensitivity of the machine. So formula for lambda is V by F. As I told you earlier, V is the speed of ultrasonic waves. V is the speed or velocity of the ultrasonic waves, and that speed varies depending on the material. For example, here I am having steel, and if I put my probe on the steel, the velocity of the ultrasonic waves which will emit and enter into this steel will be 5920 meter per second, 5920 meter per second. But if I put the same probe on some other material like aluminium, then the velocity of sound which will enter into the aluminium material will be different. That is why, because of this material. So, as per the material, this velocity differs, changes. So, in steel, the velocity is 5920. So, I will write it down, 5920, that is meter per second, and divided by frequency. Frequency is 4 MHz. So, after calculation, it will come it as 1.48 mm. Friends, if you will divide this by 4, you will get the reading in meter, because this is meter per second. Now you have to multiply it by 1000, and after multiplying it by 1000, you will get 1.48 mm, the lambda wavelength. Now the sensitivity is lambda by 4, that is lambda by 4. So 1.48 by 4 will get 0.37 mm. So it means the 4 MHz probe can detect a discontinuity up 2.37 mm. Up to means the minimum size of the discontinuity which this probe can detect is 0.37 mm. Now what happens if we take a 2 MHz probe? Lambda will be 5920 V by F, and F will be 2. So this will come as 2.96 mm. And again, lambda by 4 equal to 2.96 by 2. 0.74 mm. This is double than this. Hence, a 2 megahertz probe can detect a discontinuity minimum with 0.72 mm. It cannot detect less than this, but a 4 megahertz can detect up to 0.37. Means from here we can conclude that the frequency is more, sensitivity is more. Here the frequency is more, it can detect small discontinuity. Here sensitivity is less, it can detect more than this. So frequency is more, sensitivity is more. This is what we can conclude. But there are some exceptions. Exception is that higher the frequency, penetration will be less. Hence, we cannot go absolutely at a high number. We need to see how much the penetration will be less. So the we need to take a probe with appropriate frequency so that penetration will be sufficient. Again, higher the frequency, scattering will be more. The ultrasonic waves will scatter in the material, will not receive the entire waves. Hence, we need to choose appropriate probe with appropriate frequency. So, now I'll explain you the frequency selection. What should be the criteria for frequency selection? Now you understood the sensitivity. So I'll explain. For fine grain structures, if I say fine grain structure, it is plate, forging or flat items. The frequency should be between 2.25 megahertz to 4 megahertz. For job thickness less than or equal to 32 mm. And from 1.5 megahertz to 2.25 megahertz, job thickness more than 32 mm. So this is how we can select the probe depending upon our job thickness. Again, if it is casting, so for casting we need lesser frequency probes, that is 0.5 megahertz to 1.0 megahertz. So this is how we can select the frequency of the probe. Now friends, one more thing, wave propagation, modes of propagation of waves. See, roughly there are four types of waves. First one is longitudinal waves. This is also called as compression waves. Second one is transverse waves. Third one is surface waves. And fourth one is plate waves. Friends, this normal probe emits longitudinal wave. Normal probe and the TR probe. Sorry, this is TR probe, this is normal probe. These both probes emit longitudinal waves. The angle probe, it emits transverse. This is also called as shear waves. So what is the basic difference between these? The longitudinal waves are like this. Suppose if our material is, arrangement of molecule is like this. Wave will hit on this material and wave will propagate in this direction, and the material will also move to and fro in this direction only, to fro in the direction of propagation of the wave is propagating in this direction. Material will also, see here like this, material will probe like this, it will move forward, then it will move back. So in this manner this propagation takes place in longitudinal, whereas in transverse or shear wave, this is the direction of propagation of wave. Wave will move in this direction, but material will move perpendicular to the direction of the ultrasonic wave. This wave is moving in this direction, material is moving in the perpendicular direction. Here material is going up down, but wave is going in this manner. So this is shear wave and this is longitudinal wave. Now there is one more thing. If it is longitudinal wave, then the longitudinal sound wave travels in steel at a velocity of 5920 meter per second, whereas shear wave travels in the steel at a velocity 3250 meter per second. So friends, now you have understood some concept. This is, now I'll conclude this video. In the second video I'll explain completely the machine calibration and some more concept like dead zone, near field, resolution, like that. So I'll explain these some concepts and I'll explain the machine calibration, and along with that I'll explain how to plot DAC. Then I'll explain how to scan a material with the help of normal probe. So these are the things which I'll explain in my next video. But I need your comments. Friend, if you like this video, please give your valuable feedback and comment. And if you really like this concept and the way I have explained these matters, then please hit your like button. However, if there is some loophole in my explanation, or if there is something which I am not able to explain, then you can hit the dislike or thumbs down icon also. But friends, your comments are very important, so please write your comments, whether you like this video, why did you like this video, did you like the way I explained the things. And one more thing friends, you can share this video with your friends also on Facebook, WhatsApp or Telegram or any other social media platform. So friends, please give your likes, comments and shares, and with this I'll conclude this video. Thank you very much.